Thank you, everyone. Good morning. As you all know, I am an actor. Born in Surat, brought up in Surat, and now in Mumbai from last almost 12 years. By education, I am an engineer. I've done my diploma in mechanicals from Surat, then 1 year of job because I didn't get direct admission in degree. And then I thought that diploma is not enough. So I went to Jalgaon, North Maharashtra University, and completed my graduation in industrial engineering, which is production engineering. And all this while, since the school time, I was always into theaters. So if someone asks me that, when did you decide to become an actor, I don't have an answer to that. Because theater has become my second nature that way. So there is no right date or particular incident to it where I decided. But I grew up with theater. Theater grew up with me, within me. So that's how it happened to me. At one point, when I landed to Bombay, or even before that, after graduation, I immediately thought that there's only one place in India where I'll be able to pursue two things together. That's my engineering and acting, and that's Bombay. So I landed up there directly from my college. Lot of thoughts were going there in my mind. There were a lot of contemplation happening simultaneously together, because I was born to a family where everyone is a teacher. My entire family is into teaching business. They are all teachers. My father, mother, three uncles, aunts, my cousins, everyone. So I was the only odd man out in the family who decided to disagree with this agreement of the entire family to get into the teaching business. And I don't know what happened, but then I decided that there's only two things that I will be able to do. One is engineering and the second is acting. And as I always say in all the talks or all the interviews that I've given, that I have an issue. I have a multiple passion disorder, which I'm sure a lot of people must be going through it. A lot of things attract me. A lot of things attract me to the level where I feel getting involved to it, adding value to it. And so much so that I feel this is the thing that I want to do for the rest of my life. And there are so many things like that. It is difficult for me to sit at one place and watch one game. Immediately after 2 minutes, I want to play the game. It is difficult for me to watch somebody performing something because then I feel that I also want to do this. So it's an issue. But that issue helped me make myself what I am. I'm still learning that way. Now, when I landed up in Bombay, thinking that I'll be doing two things together. All this while, I used to do multiple things. Because after diploma, at that time, we used to have a limited seats in Gujarat. Only first two rankers in diploma will get admission in degree. And I was not one of those two. So I didn't get direct admission in degree. And a lot of friends said that this is going to be a long path now. Either you settle down with diploma, start working somewhere, and you will have corporate ladders to grow. But then diploma has some limitations in corporate world where you will be seen differently, though you are an engineer. I worked for a year as a salesman. As they say that your first job should be salesman, so you'll learn a lot. And I've experienced it. It's true. My first job was of selling industrial energy-saving products. First day at the job, a very simple, naive, though I've scored a distinction, but a first day in a professional world after the college, I was asked to sell a cooling tower fan controller system to one of the scientist firm in GIDC Surat. I went there and I am meeting a person who is himself is a doctorate in physics, which I didn't know. So my first encounter with him, and I started explaining the things which I have learned from the brochure. This is the fan controller system. It will control the cooling tower fan control fan, and that's how we save energy. And this is, and after my third, fourth sentence, he said that I don't think you're prepared. And that was the first shock. In the first day at job, you are encountering a PhD guy, and then he gave me his card. He said, I am PhD in physics. What you are saying doesn't make sense to me. And then he threw all technical questions, and I was baffled. I was so pissed and irritated with my boss that how could he do this to me? He should have either prepared me or gave me a simple call for the first day. So I was furious, and now you are a junior, you're the junior most. You can't even go and fight with him. I just went there and I told him that, sir, you should have told me. I could have prepared myself better and all. See, that this is the preparation that I wanted you to go through. So now you know that your preparation is never going to be up to the mark. There are people smarter than you there. Don't underestimate anyone that you're going to meet, be in any field. Now, this was the first lesson. And the biggest problem that I was facing is it's a salesman job. Engineering, when I was studying, I thought that I'm going to be an engineer. It is going to be a sophisticated white-collar job. AC office, I'll be working in some sophisticated systems. And the first job was there in a good, I guess, 35-degree heat. I was going on my bike, meeting some people and getting bashed. That happened for all 11 months. I've learned a lot. And then one fine day, I was thinking that diploma is not enough. I want to do a graduation. But didn't have so much money to pay for management quota or NRI quota or certain quotas which were there. So I just called up this college in Jalgaon. Directly spoke to the principal. They said, this is the scene. I have scored distinction. And I will not be able to pay any donation for the admission. So there was a pause for 5 seconds. I thought principal will not talk further with me. But then he said, you just come down, we'll work it out. So I went there. I got an admission. I started studying there. And meanwhile, when I was working back in Surat, what used to happen is the 6 hours of sleep, 8 hours of job, remaining time was a killer time. Because all my friends, school friends, they got admission in degree college. So they had different schedules. And I was the only one who had a different schedule. So suddenly you feel left out. And you feel that you have achieved little lesser than everyone around you. So the question was directly on my competence, on my skills, and on the future also that way. Because 12th, 10th, graduation, future, those are the horrifying words which gives you nightmares actually. So what I did is that I used to do a lot of theater. I just spoke to my father that this remaining time that I want to utilize. And I want to join a theater group because from last 4 years, I have not done theater because of 10, 12th and all these things. I joined one of the groups and we have a beautiful system in Surat where municipal corporation arranges theater competition every year. There are around 12 to 15 active theater groups. I joined one of the groups and I started practicing for them. So after a full day job, at night, we used to gather at one friend's place at Terrace. There was a director and we used to rehearse for a play. There is only one show in a year for which we rehearse. So throughout the year, there is good amount of excitement in us that now which play that we'll be putting up this year, who all are going to be a participant. We will be competing with the best of the groups of last year. So after all this excitement, we rehearse for almost 35 days. And then there is a show. So my first play was called Aranyarudan, a Gujarati play. And I was given a character of a security guard, Darwan, of some old zamindar. In the entire play, only one dialogue that I had to say, ke aa raha tumhara gunegar. That's it. I am there on stage for almost 2.5 hours and I had to say only one line. For that one line, I had to practice for 35 days. 35 nights. Because we all used to gather at the rehearsal space at around 9, 9:30 till 12:30 we rehearse. But that entire process actually taught me the discipline of theater. Now, that discipline is not only for theater, but that discipline that I could actually utilize in my corporate life also. It all happened, it was continued. When I took up admission in graduation, I was at Jalgaon. Jalgaon, Surat is like 6.5 hours travel by bus, by road. So what I used to do is that I used to go there, study for 5 days. Friday night, I used to travel back, come to Surat, rehearse for 2 more days, again go back on Sunday night. This is how I used to do theater and shows and all this. It went on for 3 years. Now, there was a time when I had to decide, because I'm getting a lot of appreciation there in theater also. And I had already developed enough passion for engineering also. And now there was a dilemma, which one to choose. Go to Bombay, explore yourself. I went to Bombay. Now, Bombay is that way a cruel city, but it shows you the reality. And it comes so fast to you that if you handle it well, you're there. If you don't, you will not like Bombay ever. So first few days in Bombay, I'm fortunate enough to have my relatives there. I stayed with them for almost a month. And then I decided to go out, take a place on rent, and start struggling. That so-called struggle. Because you have heard a lot about this field, that acting is all about struggle. You have stories from great actors like Amitabh Bachchan, Shah Rukh Khan, and they've all struggled a lot. Then there is success story also. But then there are people around you. Your near ones, your dear ones, your elders, your well-wishers. So there are a few dialogues that I used to listen to a lot. How will you make it big here? Do you know any Gujarati actor who has made a big name in Bollywood? Well, I didn't have any name then, that way. See, you have to have a different personality to be a hero. Okay, so that's a direct sentence on my face that you are not a hero material. Forget it. But they sugarcoat it and tell you. Now, a lot of people tried hard with all good thoughts for me that this is not a field for you. You are an engineer. You better concentrate there. Now, there was one thought constantly in my mind which was getting louder and louder day by day that why not two things together? So first, I didn't have courage to say this to people. But when I told this to one of my cousins, he said, are you mad? You cannot do two things together. Nobody is successful by doing two things together. You will lose your focus. You will not be good in any of these things. So there was a complete disagreement to my thought. And I had complete disagreement to the overall agreement of the society for this particular thought. Agreement to disagreement is a good word, good line. It is easier said than done. It is not to rebel. It is not to prove your point, but it is to prove it to yourself. I may not agree to something, but first I have to prove it to myself. And then I can come out with a lot of confidence and talk to you like this. So the only thought with me, like I was constantly fighting with me, that if I will not be able to succeed, I'll lose it. A lot of things happen. I started working as a freelance consultant. I approached a lot of people that, hi, I'm Pratik Gandhi. I stand 5 feet 11 inches tall. These are my profiles and I am available and I want to do show. You go everywhere, you meet people, and the only sentence that you hear is, we'll let you know. That's a direct no. It all happened for so many years. The only thing that I found is engineering and acting together is going to be my fate. I kept doing it. I landed up in a corporate job in 2008. There was a time which was good enough for me at that age to fall in love. I fell in love. I chased that girl for almost 2 years. I got married to her. So that was a power of focus and perseverance, which helped me in acting also that way. So with corporate job, I wanted to pursue theater. Now, with corporate job, you cannot do full-fledged commercial theater because that needs a lot of traveling. So I found out another way, which is an experimental theater, which is like this Chandrakant Bakshi and Mohan Masala, and which people so far or industry people, they don't consider it as mainstream, but it is a theater. Where I learned a lot. And one fine day, I received a message from Abhishek Jain that I am a filmmaker from Ahmedabad and I would like to meet you once. That's how Bayar happened to me. But by this time, I have called entire family, my parents, my brother, my wife. We were all in Bombay, staying in a one-room kitchen converted to 1 BHK flat in Parla. I had a decent enough job in corporate. I was struggling to create my space in theater and films. And suddenly I came to know one fine day after almost 1.5 or 2 years of my marriage that my wife is suffering from a brain tumor. That was a time where she was about to get a lead role in one of the serials. She's also a full-time actor. So she rehearsed, pilots were shot, everything was done, there was an agreement with channel that happened, and we came to know this. So our immediate reaction is that what needs to be done now? Operation. 7 days, we found a doctor, and around 10th day, she got operated. The doctor told me after 8 hours of long operation that your wife performed very well in operation theater. Now, I didn't understand this sentence, but there were layers to this sentence. That your wife performed very well. So doctor said that we did our job, but unless she had full conviction, willpower, and positive thought, she wouldn't have made it. So she had a strong disagreement to the fear of this. And that actually shook me because all this while I was struggling with two things and I never gave time to her, to my family. Because I would openly say that I led a little selfish life to juggle between two passions and to make big in this world. After that, Bayar happened, and during Bayar, we were expecting a baby in house. So now that's the time for a father, for a family, a very crucial time that you want to be with your family. You want to be with your wife. And at that time, Bayar came. I was rehearsing for my first full-length monologue, and I didn't have house. Because the house that I was staying in needs to be given back to the owner, and I didn't have enough funds to arrange a second house immediately, even on rent, because that would require me to pay 4.5 lakh rupees of deposit and then regular recurring rent. I asked my company that if you can just give me some company on accommodation for a while. They said it will take some time to arrange. So what I had to do is that I had to ask my wife to go back to her place, my parents, that I sent them to Surat. My brother was staying with my cousin, and I literally stayed in my car. Now, it sounds filmy, but that happened. And I arranged all the professional tools that I had to complete in my company. Somehow I completed that 1.5 months, and then a company could arrange accommodation for me. Things started falling in place. I wanted to be with my wife, but then I wanted to do this film also. So I asked her that, what should I do? And I guess she knew that I'm not going to agree. So she agreed to me, and she said, you better go for the film. That's how Bayar happened, which changed a lot of lives, which changed the entire industry for that matter. I'm glad to be a part of that. After 2 years, now, when Bayar, one another glitch came, that I was a part of the corporate HR industrial engineering team. One of our plants was getting commissioned. And at that time, industrial engineers are supposed to be there at plant, commissioning the entire thing with manpower planning and all. And I asked for 25 days leave. So my managers and they were said, why the leave? Because they knew that I'm doing theater. But for film, if I'm going, then it was a little difficult for them, but they all supported me. I worked remotely. After one shot, I used to open my laptop and I used to work. I used to answer mails. I was constantly in touch with the people back in office. So 25 days, Bayar happened. A lot of offers came to me and I couldn't take a single offer because now I can't ask for the leaves again. So I had to wait for 2 years to get some interesting script. After that, Wrong Side Raju came to me and I again asked for 25 days leave. When they also were sure that this is the last leave that he's asking, he'll leave us permanently. So last year, in I guess 25th August 2016, was my last day in office before the release of Wrong Side Raju, just 10 days before I left the job. Now I'm a full-time actor. But all this while, I'm glad that I disagree to a lot of agreements in society per se, in my mind per se. And the only thing I would like to share here is that constantly challenging yourself makes your life. Because in regular life, you are regular. Only in challenging times, your real metal comes out. So I guess challenges are supposed to be there in our lives. Welcome the challenges. And a real good world awaits you. Thank you, guys. Thanks a lot.